This is the second of four videos looking at the graph of some quadratic functions or parabolas. The function that we're looking at is f of x is equal to 3x squared plus 2x plus 3. When we're through, we're supposed to label the y-intercept, the x-intercepts if they exist, the vertex, and fit all that nicely onto this piece of graph paper. So here's the idea. We'll look at some details about this particular function and move from there. Here's the idea. We know this function is going to be very easy for us to find the y-intercept because that's when x is equal to 0, so the y-intercept is at 3. It would be nice to know what the x-intercepts are. That would be the question of 3x squared plus 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. If this function factors, then we'll be able to find that nicely. If it doesn't, then it's a more difficult problem. I've looked at that a little bit, and it's a hard one to factor, but here's some other questions that we can answer pretty easily. Is that if y is equal to 3, we want to find all of the x's that are at that same particular height. So here's our situation. We've got the function y is equal to 3x squared plus 2x plus 3. If y is 3, that equation becomes 3 is equal to 3x squared plus 2x plus 3. This technique is always easy for a parabola that's in general form. You find out where the y-intercept is. That's very easy to read just from the function itself. And then ask the question, what are all the x's that are at that same height? This gives us an equation saying that 3x squared plus 2x is equal to 0 because I just subtracted 3 from both sides of that equation. This always factors to allow us to factor out an x, and then we're left with the 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. So there are two values that will make this equal to 3 that will answer this question. One of them, of course, is when x is equal to 0, either of these factors being equal to 0. The other one is when 3x, I'm sorry, this was a 3x, not a 3x squared. I factored out an x out of this. It left me with an x and a 3x plus 2. So 3x plus 2 is equal to 0 is the other possibility. We already knew this one. That was what this point was all about. If x is 0, y is 3. If x is a negative 2/3, then y is 3. Negative 2/3. So let's look at that much of the graph and we'll reason further from there. So when we're at 0, we're up at 1, 2, 3. When we're at, I'm going to put my scale here at 1. When we're over here at minus 2/3, we're again up at this same height. Now because those are at the same height, the axis of symmetry will have to be halfway between those two. So the axis of symmetry, the vertex has x value equal to half of this distance from 0 to a minus 2/3. Half of the distance between 0 and a minus 2/3 is a minus 1/3. So I'm very interested in what happens when I've got a minus 1/3 for an x value. I can find out the y value that goes with that by simply calculating f at a minus 1/3, which will be 3 times a minus 1/3 squared plus 2 times a minus 1/3 plus 3. In the interest of keeping the video not too long, do those calculations and you find out that that's a value of 2. So when x is a minus 1/3, the y value is 2. So when we're here at a minus 1/3 in our graph, we're up at 2. This particular parabola is an opening up parabola because that leading coefficient is positive, and we can see that from these 3 points as well. So it's going like this. There is no x-intercept at all, but there's the y-intercept. We've already found that. And there's the vertex right there. Okay, so now we need to fit all of that onto to the graph paper here. So really we need to be working between 0, I'm sorry, this is a minus 1, 0 and a minus 1 on this particular graph. So wherever my y-axis is going to be, let's say that it's here, The real important part of the action happens between 0 and minus 1. So let's put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's put this. Let me just put the x-axis right here and the y-axis there. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is where 1 is going to be. That'll be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's where 2 will be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's where I'm going to put 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's where 1 is on this. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's a minus 1. Okay. So that will fit things fairly nicely. I can put 0, 3, that's going to be this point. I can put a minus 2/3. Now see, these are 6, so there's 1/3, there's 2/3. At a minus 2/3, I'm up here at 3. Okay, so I found those 2 points. This one is important to label because we're supposed to label the y-intercept, 0, 3. And we also found out that the vertex, because of the symmetry argument, the vertex had to be halfway between here. That would be at a minus 1/3, and it will be up at 2. So here at a minus 1/3, 2. So there at that point, minus 1/3, 2 is another point on the parabola. The parabola is coming up like this. So we've labeled the y-intercept, we've labeled the vertex, and there are no x-intercepts in this particular problem. Okay.